When it comes to life, there's few things that go from simple to sublime with only a little bit of effort. One of those is the greatness that is citrus fruit. The juice and zest of these fruits can be used to make so many things go from great to perfection. The best way to show off how great citrus fruit can be is the subtle mixture of custard and citrus juice that is lemon curd. This might be known to you by under a different name, lemon meringue pie. I want to stress that this custard does not have to be made only with lemons. It is the foundation of another citrus classic, key lime pie. The making of lemon curd is simple and one of the quickest and easiest dessert custards to make. And no one has to know, as it's so delicious that everyone will think that you took all afternoon to make it. Citrus curd does not have to be restricted to pies. It goes with everything and is great to put on fruits, cookies, biscuits, and cakes of all kinds. Lemon curd is, of course, the most versatile. I want to give a brief mention about how to pick out good citrus fruits. If it doesn't smell like anything, it's not going to taste like anything. See my episode on making lemonade for more details. As a chef, I find it fun to do experimentation in the kitchen. The universality of this custard, and that is at the base of this dessert, is something that lends itself to experimentation and tinkering. You can use just about any juice as the base of this custard. This has led me to do something that is very surprisingly good. And I'll let my brother talk about what it's like to be one of my many taste testers when I'm coming up with new recipes.
The opportunity to try new tastes and recipes that my brother creates is a risky one. But I am brave enough, though, to try just about anything that is edible. Sometimes this is a home run, while other times it ends up striking out. Boone Spice turned out to be one of the wonderful additions to many, many recipes. This cornbread experiment, though, turned out to be a better as a centerpiece than to be eaten.
The dessert that I came up with was a grapefruit meringue pie. I did this the first time when I was making a batch of lemon curd to find out that a roommate had used my lemons, and they were my Uncle Mike's lemons. And so I used his grapefruits to make my pie with. That pie tasted great, but the grapefruits that I had used to make it with didn't have strong color in the zest. So the filling looked a bit funny, but tasted fine. So in the next batch I made on purpose, I added a few drops of red food coloring, and that time it looked perfect. At the party for a good friend of mine, we brought both a lemon pie and a grapefruit pie, and the grapefruit pie went first. Take the crackers one packet at a time and buzz them up in your food processor. If you do not have a food processor, use a large Ziploc bag and a rolling pin and just put the crackers in the bag and roll them until they're broken up fine. Just drop the crackers in and turn it on. When the crackers are broken up fine, stir into them the sugar. Your spices. Just a pinch of your nutmeg, and a pinch of your ground cloves, and two heavy pinches of your cinnamon. And just buzz this to combine. Now keep in mind that this would be a recipe for three pie crusts. So just half everything by a third.
Now stir in the melted butter.
Stir until well combined. Okay, this is about what it should look like when you're done stirring it together. Now, in a pie tin, fill it with your crust material, and you're going to want to carefully tap it down with a large tablespoon. And don't worry about putting too much in the pan to start with. You can always remove it later, and that's a lot easier than trying to add more once you've got this going. You're going to want to tamp this down until it's firm and well compacted. Now this may take a while, so just work hard until you have it all nice and together. And once you have a crust put together, place it in the fridge until you need it. You will get the best results if you let this sit overnight. You could also toast the crust before you put it in the fridge if you want to, but that's optional. The toasted crust will always taste better. The first thing that you need to do is separate the yolk from the whites, as the white doesn't do much for making a good custard. There is also a second reason, as this is in to be used in your fluffy meringue. If you aren't making this to be part of a pie, then your white will end up forgotten and forlorn. There is a way to take care of this. After separating the white from the yolk, inspect it carefully, then pour it into an ice tray to be frozen and then stored for using later. Inspect the whites very carefully, as even one speck of yolk will spoil the whole batch. So practice safe separating. Use a little custard cup on the side, and before you put your white with any of the other whites you've already separated, make sure there's not even a speck of yolk, because even one tiny little dot of yolk is enough to destroy any meringue. There is also a good reason to stockpile whites for using later, as many recipes calling for beaten egg whites want more whites than the yolks in the adjoining custard, including this one. Mix together the flour, the starch, the salt, and the sugar, and slowly stir into this the water and juice mix. Stir until the sugar has completely dissolved. Reserve 1/3 cups of your lemon juice for later. And over medium heat, stir constantly until the custard comes to a boil. Boil for 3 minutes. Now remove from the heat, and in a medium-sized bowl, beat the egg yolks until they lighten in color.
and then add the juice and the zest to the egg yolks. Now, add the hot custard mix to the eggs slowly, at about a third into the eggs. This is to temper the egg yolk.
And here's making a mess.
Keep stirring, or else you will get sweet scrambled eggs. Now, mix this back in to the pot. Mix this very slowly and then return to medium heat. And return this to a boil. Once it has returned to a boil and starts to look like something you'd see at Yellowstone, boil this for at least 3 minutes. This is important. In order for the egg to work properly, it needs to be cooked for at least 3 minutes. There are proteins and enzymes in the egg yolks making wonderful things happen, but they need to be cooked for it to work properly.
Also, there's enzymes in the eggs that eat the starch. So you need to disarm those.
After your time is up, remove it from the heat. Now, mix in the butter. And let it melt. Stir constantly until the butter and custard has completely combined. Now you have lemon curd. This delicious concoction goes on all sorts of everything. But what it's best for is lemon pie. So pour it into your pie crust. Step to do. Put the meringue on top. When you're filling a pie crust, make sure you fill it so there's at least a quarter inch below the rim, so that there's room to attach the meringue to the crust, and it helps keep the lemon in the crust. Place this now in a 200 degree oven to keep warm until you have the fluffy cloud to go on top. Ready.
This custard will not stick to the meringue if it is not warm. You have to keep it at the temperature you pulled the custard at until you're ready to put the meringue on top.
A grapefruit pie is just the same as the lemon pie. The only difference is, because of the hue of the yolks, it will dominate over the color of the grapefruit, so it needs a little bit of help. A couple of drops of red food coloring should solve this.
Now comes the fun part. In a very clean bowl, and I mean clean, do not mix this ever in a plastic bowl. Plastic is made from oil, and so oils and fats love to stick to them. So no matter how good of a job you do cleaning a plastic bowl, there will always be more than enough fat sticking to it to end your fluffy endeavors. Place in your bowl the egg whites, the water, the cream of tartar, and the vanilla. With the hand whisk, whip these together gently. Once you have the cream of tartar dissolved, start whipping the mixture on low speed on your mixer. If you have a whisk attachment, use this to start with. Slowly add the sugar. Some air, switch over to your standard beaters and turn the mixer up to medium speed. Beat until you get to soft peaks. You will know when you reach this. You'll know you've reached soft peaks when you take the beaters in, dip it in, and pull them out, and the peaks droop right away. Now, turn your juice up on your mixer to ludicrous speed, and beat until you get to stiff peaks. The way to know when you've reached stiff peaks is dip in the beaters and pull them out. If the peaks stick, stand right up. And they don't wiggle, well, at least a little bit, they'll wiggle. Wiggle a little. Now you're at stiff peaks. This is now meringue. You're done beating them. Now with a spatula, place this over the warm pie custard and carefully smooth it down over the edges of the pie. Carefully smooth it down over the edges of the pie to make sure you get a good seal. Smooth off the top to make a nice, neat finish. Now, to add a little bit of a flair in the decoration, we like to dab it with the spatula and give it some curling peaks. Now, place this into a 350 degree oven and bake for 10 to 15 minutes until the top peaks are golden brown. Make sure you keep an eye on this because it can go from perfect to overdone in seconds.
There's the beauty. Nice golden top piece. That's a perfect done. Now lemon meringue pie.
Key lime pie. This is the creme a la creme of cream pies. It is a lime custard that is folded into whipped cream that is quick because it requires no baking. Place your bowl and beaters into the freezer for at least 2 hours. Now, place your gelatin into a small saucepan filled with approximately 2 tablespoons of water. And let this sit in a room temperature place for at least an hour. Slowly warm the water over low heat until the gelatin has dissolved. At this time, pour the gelatin into the cream. In the chilled bowl, whip cream with bloomed gelatin. Stir in 2 tablespoons of sugar slowly as you whip. Don't worry, this will be plenty of sugar, and the rest is going to come from your custard, so don't worry. Reserve 1/4 of the whipped cream for the top. 3/4 of the whipped cream goes in the filling. The rest is decoration. Put this in the fridge and keep it chilled. Now let's make a batch of custard. Lime custard is the same as lemon, just use limes and add some green color. You may not need the green color at all. It will depend on how well your lime zest colors your custard. I usually needs only 1 or 2 drops. Whip cream again quickly to fluff it up a bit. Completely mix 1/3 of the reserved whipped cream into the warm custard. Now, gently fold in half the remaining whipped cream. Do this again with the remaining whipped cream.
It's all right at the last step to have a few streaks of light colors and white cream. That shows that you made it from scratch. Pour the key lime pie filling into your crumb crust till it's about a quarter inch from the top. And voila, there it is. That's a key lime pie. Only thing left to do now is decorate. Decorating a key lime pie with the remaining whipped cream, however you like. But be creative about it. And voila, your key lime masterpiece is finished. Put this in the fridge to chill, and you're done.
Jellyfish inside a beet.
Yuck!
Why should we eat the same old meals? Wait till you taste my garlic eels. There are so many things to make: a custard soup, a liver cake, a curry pie with prunes and squash. How about leftovers goulash? Hey!
Nothing brown and nothing soupy, nothing slippery and nothing gloopy, nothing mashed and nothing steamed, and nothing runny with eyes or feet that smells or wiggles when you're touching on crust.
There are so many things to
like
make: a custard soup, a liver cake, a curry pie with prunes and squash. How about some leftovers goulash? Hey! Take a pot and add a lot of codfish mash and kidney hash. Let's add some snails and catfish tails and brains and feet. Can't wait to eat! A sloppy scoop of runny clip, a squid on toast, a rhubarb roast, some tofu stew with extra goulash, leftover squash. It's called goulash. Hey!